Major, there's a girl in here.
Is she alive?
My name is Mary Lennox. Where has everyone gone? Where's my Aya?
We've searched the servants' bungalow as well, sir. It's just one black snake and this girl.
Why has no one come for me?
I'm afraid there's no one left, miss.
Bloody miracle she escaped it, though. God knows how. She was drinking the same water they was.
But where are my mother and father?
I'm sorry, miss.
Where shall I take the girl, sir? Our orders are to burn anything that might be contaminated.
To the governor's house, for now, till we find some family somewhere.
Yes, sir. You'll have to leave that picture here, miss.
No, I will not. I'm taking it with me.
It's your pretty mother, is it?
No, it isn't.
Yes, well, come along then.
Can it be your dream? Surely it must seem like a frightful dream. How can this be true?
Won't her mother come?
Come
wake her up to play. Won't her father say, here's a rose for you?
There's a girl who no one sees. There's a girl who's left alone. There's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known. For the life she's never
Sorry to call you home like this, Archie, but I felt sure you'd want to respond quickly. Here it is. It's from the governor's office in Bombay. We're sorry to inform you that Captain Albert Lennox and his wife Rose have died of the cholera. All in compound have perished, save their daughter Mary. They want to send the girl here. It seems they found an old will naming you as Mary's guardian.
This is no house for a child.
I couldn't agree more. We'd simply have to locate an appropriate boarding school that will accept her midterm.
Quite right, sir. There's a convent school not 20 miles away. I'm sure they'd be quite willing to
Tabitha
have a
fill the laundry tubs day and night. Thank you, Mrs. Medlock. The girl is Lily's niece. She will come here.
But she doesn't have to come here, Archie. We can simply locate an appropriate school and they can send her there directly.
Do you remember how Lily and Rose would run across the moor as girls? The lace dresses blowing in the wind.
But what will she have to do here, Archie? Wander the halls?
We could engage a governess, Doctor. That should at least provide her with lessons and someone to look after her.
She needs the company of other children, Medlock, particularly after a tragedy such as this.
Not the gloomy one, Lily. You can't be serious.
He's only sad, Rose, sad for being alone for so long. Archie has the tenderest heart I've ever known.
No. Let our young Mary come here to mourn her loss. And when she has recovered, we'll decide what is best for her. Give me the wire. I'll make the arrangements myself.
Silly Lily. Have you been so busy looking into his eyes you missed the hump on his back?
Shall I prepare the girl's room then, Doctor?
It's the worst thing my brother could possibly do for the child.
And Mrs. Medlock, order the child some clothes. I won't have her dressed in black, wandering about like a lost soul. It would make the house sadder than it is.
Yes, sir.
And you will go to London to meet her and bring her here?
Yes, sir.
Good then.
There's a girl who no one sees. There's a girl who's left alone.
There's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known. For the life she's never
mad must have been for the girl to wander up to in the middle of a party, then to wake up the next morning with them all dead.
Good evening, Major. I'm Mr. Creighton's housekeeper. Is this the girl?
Yes, ma'am. And her papers and the death certificates and all. Her father was captain of my regiment, and a fine man he was too. We're all very sorry.
Thank you, Major.
Yes, ma'am. A pleasant journey to you, ma'am.
Well, now I'd suppose you'd like to know something about where you were going.
Would I?
But don't you care about your new home?
It doesn't matter whether I care or not.
Now, in all my years, I have never seen a child sit so still and look so old.
High on the hills is a big old house with something wrong inside it. Spirits haunt the halls and make no efforts now to hide. children's names and speak of one who's crying.
Well, you're right not to care. Why you're being brought to Miss Awaith, I'll never know. Your uncle isn't going to trouble himself about you, that's sure certain. He never troubles himself about anyone.
And the master hears the whispers on the stairways dark and still, and the spirits speak of secrets in the house upon the hill.
He's a hunchback, you see, and a sour young man he was, and got no good of all his money and a big place till he were married.
To my mother's sister.
Her name was Lily, and she was a sweet, pretty thing. And he would have walked the world over for her to get her single blade of grass that she wanted. Nobody thought she'd marry him, but marry him she did, and it wasn't for his money either. But then, when she died,
made
him worse than ever. He travels most of the time now, so you needn't expect to see him, because 10 to 1, you won't.
Big old house with something wrong inside it. Someone died and someone's left alone and can't abide it. There in the house is a lonely man still haunted by her.
Take her to her room. He does not want to see her.
Very good, Doctor.
Can it be a dream? Surely it does seem like a frightful dream. No one here she knows. Shadows on the walls, dark and drafty halls, catch her if she falls, still no fear she shows.
Well, here you are. This room and the next are where you live. But you mustn't expect that there'll be people to talk to you. You'll have to play about and look after yourself. But when you're in the house, don't go wandering in the halls. Your uncle won't have it.
Won't have it.
Albert, please.
Rose, you and Mary must leave this city until we get this cholera under control.
And what shall I do? Wander around the hills alone with the child while she just stares at me the whole time?
She's not staring at you, Rose. Mary just wants to look at you, just like all the rest of us.
Good night, then.
Yes, ma'am.
There's a girl who no one sees. There's a girl who's left alone. There's a heart that beats in silence for the life she's never known.
Could it be? Maybe it was mother.
I heard someone singing. Who though could it be? Maybe it was Lily calling out to me. Maybe she's not gone so far away as I've been told. I heard someone singing. Maybe it was she.
Maybe it was someone I could find and have a cup of tea. Maybe it was someone who could bring the tea and come find me.
I heard someone crying, though I can't say who. Someone in this house with nothing left to do. Sounded like a father left alone, his love grown cold. I heard someone crying. Maybe it was you.
Maybe I was dreaming of a garden growing far below. Maybe I was dreaming of a life that I will never. Lily, where are you? I'm lost without you. I can't walk these halls without you. Lily, where are you? I need you. I have searched the world, but you're not there. Come and tell me why you brought me home if you're not there. Lily, where are you? I'm lost without you. Lily, where are you? I need you. I'm some trace you left behind. Lily, where are you?
For he gives his heart away and makes a nest and all the rest. I told me, darling mother, there is something he mun do.
Are you my servant?
Well, there, marry, Lennox. Me name is Martha, and now that you're up, I'll make the bet.
Aren't you going to dress me first?
Can you dress thyself, then?
In India, my ayah dressed me.
Well, then, it'll do thee good to wait on thyself a bit. 'Tis fair a wonder grand folks' children don't turn out fair fools, being washed and kept like they was puppies.
What is this language you speak?
Well, of course. You've not heard any Yorkshire living in India, have you? Mrs. Medlock said I'd have to be careful or you wouldn't understand what I was saying. But I didn't know what to expect from you either, lassie. When I heard you was coming from Bombay, I thought you'd be a solid brown, I did. But you're not brown at all. More yellow, I'd say.
It's the natives who are brown.
Well, maybe I was hoping you'd be brown as Mother Truth of it. I've never seen a brown person. Now, lassie, you mustn't cry like that. Didn't know you'd be so easy vexed. I'll help you on with your clothes this time if you like. You just pretend you're back in India, and I'm your servant, and you give me that little yellow
foot. I'm quite all right, thank you.
Look there, out the window. It's the moor, it is. Like a dull purple sea this morning. Do you like it?
I hate it.
Ah, you wait till spring. For the moor is fair covered in gorse and heather, and there's such a lot of fresh air. My brother Dickon goes and plays on the moor for hours. He's got a pony that's made friends with him, and birds and sheep and such as eat right out of his hands.
Those are not my clothes.
Hi, miss, your uncle bought
you. These are nicer than mine.
You get these new clothes on, then, and wrap up warm and run out and play. That'll give you stomach for your porridge.
Mrs. Medlock told me there's nothing out there but a big old park.
Well, maybe you'll run into our Dickon out there. Maybe he'll give you a ride on his pony. Maybe he'll take...
I don't know anything about boys.
If I had a fine white horse, I'd take you for a ride today. But since I have no fine white horse inside, I'll have to stay and empty all the chamber pots and scrub the floors and such.
What set her to on a fine white horse? It seems to me not much. If I had a wooden boat, I'd take it for a sail today. But since I have no wooden boat inside, I'll have to stay and catch and kill the mice and pluck the chickens for the cook. Oh, what's there to do on a wooden boat but sit up straight and look? And worry our boats would start to drift and float us out to sea and land us on an isle of gold. Oh, dearie me, if I had a chambermaid, I'd take you out to play today. They say that there's a maze where once you enter, there you stay. For certain we'd get lost and they'd come looking for our pawns and find us sometime late next week and bring us tea in scones. Oh, what if there's a clan of trolls a-camp in the tree? Oh, what if there's a pirate's cave? Oh, dear, oh, dear. Oh, dearie me, if I wasn't so afraid, I'd take you out the door today. But talking birds and tales of fairies keep me scared away. And yes, I promised not to tell what else is there, although if in the maze you chance to see a garden guarded by a tree and meet a bird who speaks to thee, then come and tell my fine white horse and me. Now there's Mrs. Menlock's bell, and I've got all this to clean up first. Could you find your way out yourself, then? It's past the ballroom
I'll find it.
Mary Lennox, I thought you might like a skipping rope to play with. Mary Lennox. Ah, forget the rope.
I saw in a valley a girl I hardly knew, a girl at work in a garden grew to love me.
From the gate he called out so kindly, "Lest would thou
share my tea," she bade me so gently, "oat cakes and cream, sweet plums in a jar."
And every day to my valley, this man, who might he be, came bearing baskets of roses, for he
I give
just a garden.
All I would ask is never to
leave. Say you'll have me safe, you will keep me where you.
there I would,
there we would go.
Archibald.
Who's that?
It's Mary Lennox, sir. Are you my Uncle Archibald?
Yes, I am. Good morning, child.
Are you going to be my father now?
I am your guardian, though I am a poor one for any child. I offer you...
Is this my Aunt Lily in this picture?
Where did you get that?
It was on my dresser in India. Maybe Mother put it there. I don't know.
Your mother and my Lily... Please excuse me. Who dressed you, child?
Martha tried to, sir.
Yes. I see. I do hope you'll enjoy the gardens.
But I wanted to know what happens to dead people.
Yes. Quite naturally, you should wonder that. We bury them. We put the things away. We remember the things they said. We talk to them sometimes. Well, in our minds, of course.
Can they hear us?
And then one morning when we think we're over them at last, we find ourselves in the ballroom, knowing full well we have been here all morning. And we draw the painful conclusion that we have been dancing with them again.
I don't understand.
Nor will you ever, child. They're not gone, you see. Just dead.
Is my Aunt Lily a ghost now?
Why? Have you heard her?
I heard someone crying in the house last night. But I don't know anything about ghosts. Is my father a ghost now? Does everyone who dies become a ghost?
They're only a ghost if someone alive is still holding on to them.
Maybe what I heard was Mother telling me to be nice, so you'll keep me.
The house is haunted, child, day and night. But it is yours to live in for as long as I am master here. I offer you my deepest sympathies on your arrival.
Did my mother have any other family?
Plant a hedge, cut it back. Dig a hole, try to fill it. Plant a rose, tie it back. Find a mole, try to kill it. It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of ways. Any man can spend his day. It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of paths. But a soul can find the way. For an old man knows how a year it goes. How the cold, hard ground in the spring comes round. How the seeds take hold and the ferns unfold. How an English garden grows.
Skip, skip the ladies to the master's gate. Sip, sip the ladies while the master ate. Tiptoe the chambermaid who stole their pearls. Tip, skip the gardener and cut off their curls.
It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of ways. Any man can spend his day. It's a maze, this garden, it's a maze of paths. But a soul can find the way.
For an old man knows how a year it goes. How the cold, hard ground in the spring comes round. How the seeds take hold and the ferns unfold. How an English garden grows.
Skip, skip.
skip the ladies to the master's gate. Skip, skip the ladies while the master ate.
Come along, love, come fly away. Fly along, come along, fly away home.
It's a maze to spot him, it's a maze on hands. But to lead a man astray.
Take a left and then turning left again. How a soul can find the way. For an old man knows,
it's a maze to scot him,
how a year
it's
a
maze of ways,
how a cold
heart
drowns
in a fly away
home. How in time it flows, how
a
god
in fly away home. Skip, skip the ladies to the master's gate. Sip, sip the ladies while the master ate.
Tiptoed the chambermaid who stole their pearls. Sip, sip the gardener and cut off their curls. Good morning, Ben.
Back again today, are you? What have you been doing out there?
Just wandering around. I don't have anybody to play with and nothing to do.
Dickens here. Why don't you go talk to him? I saw him myself not 5 minutes ago conjuring with that stick of his.
I haven't met Dickens. I'm not sure he even exists. I think you and Martha just made him up.
Well, then I'll give you a spade if you want to dig a little hole somewhere.
A little hole for what?
You know something? You and me are a good bit alike. We're neither of us good looking, and each as sour as we look.
I saw that Robin again today.
I'm sure you did. There never was his like for being meddlesome. He's the real head gardener around here. Always chirping at me to come see some bush needs pruning.
I know where he lives too. It's that square garden with the tall hedge all around it and no door and that funny looking tree growing out of the top of the wall. I think that tree is the same one my Aunt Lily is sitting in that picture I have. Am I right?
That's it, Missy. That's the one. That was Miss Lily's garden.
Her garden? But I want to see it. Can you show me the door?
No, I can't. When she died, your uncle said no one was ever to come into this garden again. He locked the door and he buried the key. Now the ivy's grown up over the door such that I don't even know where it is now.
But aren't you worried that the garden is all dead with nobody taking care of it?
Of course I am. But if I so much as set foot in there, then
maybe
I'm as good
the
as
real
fired.
Reason the robin is chirping at you is he wants you to climb over his garden wall and work on it.
Maybe he does. But I can't go losing my job on the advice of a bird now, can I?